Hello, everyone. My name is Claire Rumore, and I'm co-director and senior faculty member at the Shakti Shiva Academy. And I'm so happy to have Dr. Willow Brown joining me today. We're going to share a little bit about an upcoming beautiful event that Dr. Willow is putting together. And she's very graciously, and I'm so grateful, has invited me to speak at, but it's called Dreaming the Queen Awake. And it's an online one-day retreat happening June 12th. And so first, Dr. Willow, I'd love for you to introduce yourself, please, and then share with us the inspiration behind the event.
Yeah, thanks, Claire. I'm thrilled that you are going to be one of our speakers. I'm so excited to have you on the panel. So this event is coming together in the name of supporting women in finding that mindset of the queen, that mindset of the sovereign one. So that's really a mindset of making choices in your life that you truly, truly want to make, like listening to your heart's truth and following that path instead of making choices that other people want you to make, or being the person that, you know, your parents or your husband or your society really want you to be. So, you know, are you harboring the mindset of a queen, or are you harboring the mindset of a servant? And maybe there's sectors or areas in your life where you really are standing in that mindset of the queen and you know it and you're strong in those areas. And then maybe there's some other areas where you could use a little bit more support, a little bit more practice in that, and really moving out of that mindset of like, I'm going to work hard for you and give up myself in order for your happiness. And, you know, we just see that really across the board with women, and it's nobody's fault. It just is been, you know, the practice for eons. And so I feel like at this point in time, we're really breaking out of that old paradigm as women, and it's an exciting moment in life. So I wanted to bring together some queens like Claire, some sovereign women, some beings who really walk their talk, who really do their practices and show up in the world as leaders and helping and supporting men and women, you know, in finding their sovereignty. This event is particularly for women, and we're going to be doing a lot of kind of movement, not so much interview sitting style and listening, but more getting in your bodies and feeling into where do you give yourself up for others, and how can you start to shift that so that the world around you starts to reflect your inner sovereign being.
That's so beautiful. And I know you are a very skilled doctor of Chinese medicine and acupuncturist, and you specialize in sexuality and hormones. So I'm wondering, I can imagine that a lot of the women that you see in your practice have been in this more subservient or exhausted, you know, always putting others first mindset. Again, nobody's fault. It's our conditioning. It really is. And so, how have you, I imagine you've created this event with them in mind.
Yes, it's true. I mean, a lot of people who come to my practice are adrenally depleted, and their hormones are all out of whack, and they're not having satisfying sex lives. And it's all tied together. You know, it can seemingly be separate things, but it really is all tied together when we look at first, second chakra, survival versus thrival, and sexuality, and, you know, even abundance, finances, all of that. So it's really all tied in there. Like, how committed are you to being in your physical body on the earth at this time? There's a lot of people exiting stage left. They don't, you know, they're done, or spirit's taking them, or whatever. Mm-hmm. And so it's a powerful time to claim your physicality and claim your body. And so that's, you know, that's why we're going to be doing so many embodiment practices to really help you get grounded in that, those lower chakras that connect you to the earth, because we're not just part of the earth. We are the earth. We are earthlings of the earth. All the energy that runs through the earth runs through us as well. And when we know how to navigate that and use it as medicine for our benefit, life transforms and becomes much more enjoyable.
Which we need after this year plus of COVID and quarantines and sheltering in place. you know, it's time to reclaim our embodiment and our bodies. And I know that the retreat itself is going to be online, so it'll be accessible to anyone anywhere on the planet. And so we're not yet meeting in person, but we're bringing the best of that through Zoom.
Yeah, absolutely. So the beauty of having it online is you can come in from anywhere, but we will be live. We will be interacting with you live. So that will be a beautiful aspect as well. And then what we really want you to do is to invite people from your pod that you can be close with in your home. Invite your sisters, your cousins, your girlfriends, invite a couple friends over to so that you have that experience of doing it in the flesh with other women.
That's so great. So we can still have community and connection, even if we're spread out around the world. We can create that in our own home spaces, or it can just be our own self interacting with the event.
Absolutely.
That will be extremely powerful.
Come as you are, for sure.
I love that.
All of yourself.
I love that. When you asked me to speak, you know, there's this big repertoire of things we could possibly speak about because the Queen is so vast. And the idea that came to me was, well, let's just address that the Queen has many faces. And some of those faces are very oppositional. They're very contradictory, or what we call polarities at the Shakti Shiva Academy. And so I'm really excited that we're going to be talking about and living, embodying these polarized experiences of the Queen. The Queen can be glorious and generative and generous. She also can be dried up and cranky and miserly. And in terms of the totality that we talk about in the courses at Shakti Shiva Academy, it's important that we honor all the faces of the Queen and not exclude a part of her or a part of ourself, because then that's when we start to shrink and we start to experience what you were talking about.
Yes, absolutely. It doesn't, being the Queen, the sovereign one in your life, doesn't mean you're always got your glory on and your crown on it. It means that you're present with what's true for you in that moment. Yeah. That's the sovereignty piece.
That is the sovereignty piece. And really eliminating judgment, eliminating upset about feeling upset about something. It's about embracing. It's about being with, accepting, acknowledging, and loving all parts of ourselves. Just that alone enhances vitality, as you know, through your work. Absolutely. So yeah, so the event is coming up June 12th. And there's going to be fabulous. And there's going to be other speakers. Share with us about some of the other speakers.
So we have some really good speakers. I'm so excited. We've got, we're going to be doing like some art kind of therapy work with Dr. Kiara Barr. We've got another speaker who's a Sunny Rose. She's an Ayurvedic specialist. So we're going to be doing Abhyanga, so full body oil love massage. That's going to be really sweet. So bring a bikini or something like that. Bring a bathing suit. And we've got some dance. We've got some Qigong we're going to be doing. You know, we're going to we have one more speaker slot to fill. So we'll see who fills that. Mm. But, we're going to have a good time and really set ourselves up for success moving forward in embodying that archetype of the Queen. And really standing in your truth without apology, without hesitation, and just showing up fully in your life, you know, that creates these boundaries that people can respect. Then they know where they stand. If you know where you stand, people know where they stand. And that makes, you know, good fences make good neighbors. Like that makes for good relationships. So we really want to build up and bolster up your relationship with your own body, your own sensuality, your own sexuality, so that the relationships around you can thrive.
Mm, that's so beautiful. I'm excited to even participate as well as contribute and speak, because this is such an important theme, and it's such an important commitment right now, especially as the world is starting to open back up and we're starting to interact with others after a long period of being inside and very internal or introverted, or you know, just plain miserable for some of us. And how to come back into the world in a way where we own who we are, where we're at, but we're not like shoving others out of the way, and learning that fine dance, that really, really fine art.
Yes.
Being a queen in the world and making space for other queens and other kings.
Exactly. Yes. And really eliminating that old paradigm mentality of like jealousy and envy around other women. If you see other women rocking it, like, be happy for them. That's possible for you too. There's no separation between you and them. So we want to feel that right in our soma and our cells and our body, in our wombs and our bodies. So we're going to do that.
So glorious. And so in keeping with even the book that Shakti Milan, founder of the Shakti Shiva Academy, wrote called Sexual Awakening for Women, and some of the courses that we teach at the school about this very thing. It's like how to be alive in your feminine beauty and radiance and be weaving a sisterhood where other women, other females get to be, other feminine beings get to be in their radiance also.
Absolutely.
And that way we enliven the world and bring about
that's
this new world that we are so excited about.
That's right. Yeah.
Yay.
To do. Let's do it together.
We're doing it
on June 12th.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So all the details are with the link accompanying this video. So be sure to check it all out. And we'd love for you all to join us. We're very excited about what's going to be sprouting from these shares. And this coming together of the beautiful, divine, feminine, radiant queen.
Yes, cannot wait. I'm so excited. And Claire, I'm so excited for your class and your offering. It's going to be amazing.
Thank you, Willow, for joining us today. It's so good to have you here.
My pleasure. Thank you.